Hello there, back with another one. This playlist demonstrates how to create layouts with grid and flex in Droip. Well, websites aim to deliver value through content, communication, and smooth navigation. Considering that, grids and flex are essential for organizing content, so it gets easier for users to find the apt thing. And thus, a smooth communication channel is built. In today's video, we will explore how to use grids for showcasing items. Grids are incredibly versatile, allowing you to create intricate, responsive designs. With Droip, it's even easier to place objects exactly where you need them. While dynamic layouts are mostly used to display products or items, but for today, we will focus solely on static layouts. So, starting with our blank editor, we will avoid creating everything from the beginning, rather, we will use symboled components here. To do that, let's just take a section for now. Set the background color to white for this section. After that, let's fast forward, go to layers, symbol, and then select others category. And here in the bottom, we have this header one component. Drag it down to the section we have, and it's that smooth. Next, we would set a divider maybe that will have the navigation menus. And we will apply the same process. Take a section and then, instead of setting the color manually, let's just simply assign the class we have for the top section. Yes, that is another way of reusing styles. Now let's go to layers, then symbol and others category. Drag down the divider 1 to this new section and voila, we're done. Now, let's check the design we are following. So, we can see the structure here has a rhythm. Notice the diagonal from the upper right to the lower left. The plan is, we will take a 4x3 grid. By doing so, we will have 4 blocks in each row. And to make this rhythm here, we will combine 2 blocks to make an area. So, let's hop onto our editor. Let's take a section. Set the class like we used before. Then take a container. Set the background color to white. And also set the size to 80% in the width. After that, type grid and drag it down here. So now that we have the skeleton for the grid, we have plenty of ways to assign the 4x3 structure. First, we have the explicit grid controller mode, and you can set the rows and columns and also the grid gaps from here easily. Then we have structure in our style panel that gives extensive options to set your grid according to preference. And lastly, you can adjust your layout from the inline editor as well. So we have some presets here, and also you can set custom layouts from down here. Let's set ours, 4 columns and 3 rows. Done. Now we will go to the grid controller mode. Make sure all our blocks are of equal dimension. Dragging the panel up here for better visuals. Now with the plus icon over this block, we will set the area label. So we want these two blocks to form one area. Simply, we will rename the label and that's it. Let's make some similar areas in 3, 2, 1. And there we have them. Now it's best practice to fill each block with individual divs so that the contents are arranged neatly. So to do that, what we will do is search for div and drag it down here in the blocks. We will house all of our grid blocks with divs in 3, 2, 1, all set. So now we have our layout similar to the design. Next, the task is pretty simple. We will go to symbols again and others, then drag these components one by one and paste them in the divs of our grid blocks. With each drag and drop, let's detach the component from symbol so we can edit further if necessary. For convenience, let's just preview one symbol from here, let's say category 1. It has a basic structure, a div and an image, a minimal padding, and a border and a size to fit. Let's go back to our main editor again. Let's rename the elements in a blink so it is easier for us to track. Now let's drag and drop the symbols again according to our design. Row 2 is almost done and row 3 is also set. See, it takes just a few minutes to prepare your layout and input contents within a fun structure. Before anything, let's just alter the images. And for this row 2, let's give this a background and text color. We will also use the same concept of reusing styles here. Now for column 1, we will eliminate the left paddings for image. Simply assign a class and make the alters. And also for column 3, we will eliminate the padding from row 1 column 3 element. And row 3 column 3 element. See, it's that easy. So in our case, we have tried to place items this way, but you can certainly have better ideas to lay out them. Let us know in the comments below how you tried yours. We will be back with another complex structure in no time. Till then, stay tuned.